Donegal County Council has invested significantly in the development of 5 public services centres as part of its decentralisation programme. Its headquarters are still in Lifford, while the decentralised centres are located strategically around the county, in Carndonagh, Letterkenny, Milford, Dunloe and Donegal Town. The council provides the full range of council services from these locations. In addition, the council has, in cooperation with other agencies, encouraged the co-location and availability of a wide range of public services from the public services centres. This includes the following public bodies: Citizens Information Services, Health Services Executive, Department of Social Protection, Revenue Commissioners, National Roads Authority, Foss and Chagosk. The most northerly of the public services centres is in Carndonagh, on the Inishowen Peninsula, which has a population greater than Leitrim.
Whenever you have 40,000 people, to expect them, I think, to go to one central location in Lifford is unrealistic. And certainly there is a demand locally for it, given the numbers that we've had coming into the building and availing of services of the various agencies.
The modern centres provide a huge range of services.
They can apply to tax their car, renew their driving licence, they can apply for planning permission, they can look at a planning application that affects them, they can apply for a housing loan, they can apply for grants for people with disabilities. If there's a problem with their water supply, they can talk to the relevant people. All the decisions are actually made in the office and signed off in the office, and the relevant people who are involved in making the decision are based in the office. So if a member of the public wants to talk to the relevant person, they're here. They're convenient, they're local. The numbers of people coming to Letterkenny Public Service is increasing all the time. Last year there was over 60,000 motor tax transactions carried out. There were 7,000 other customers came to the public counters, and there was 25,000 phone calls. And that numbers are increasing on a year-by-year basis.
The public services centres have reduced considerably the distances that many people have to travel when availing of services.
If you look at the size and scale of County Donegal, many people previously would have had to travel maybe up to 50 miles to Lifford to conduct their business. We look after most of the Gaeltacht area in the county, and being located in what is the primary town in the northwest seaboard of Donegal, it's obviously an enormous advantage to people. And in that regard, people obviously can conduct most of their business on a personal one-to-one basis.
In addition, Donegal County Council has engaged extensively with the partner agencies on the County Development Board, and in particular has developed very strong relationships with the community and voluntary sector through its Community and Enterprise Division. Council officials work closely with the public in advancing a variety of projects.
We act as a link to organisations outside the council. For example, at a county development board level, we would link into the likes of the HSE, into Engard Síochána, into the local development companies. So a lot of the work, I suppose, fundamentally, while the council is a partner or, you know, has a role to play, really our role is much more expanded than that. We would, depending on what the projects are, we would be working with a range of partners, and we would develop opportunities for communities to participate in projects across the counties. And Barrackhill Town Park has helped us to realise that. One of the things we're looking at developing up there is a community garden hybrid model with allotments and a community garden function. And in order to kind of get that to a point where we've been able to achieve that, we've had to link very closely with the likes of the HSE and with the Institute of Public Health in Ireland. You know, so that's not a traditional kind of way in which we would approach work, but in order to get the fundamentals of that addressed around, you know, what impact it would have on the local community, what's the benefit of doing it, we needed to look at a way in which we can contextualise that in order to make an application for funding. So, you know, it's always about taking the layers apart and being able to see it for what it is, and then being able to develop it in such a way that it gives it meaning for the local community, and that they feel an ownership, you know, for the project or for the piece of work that you're doing.
The council has also taken the lead role in a very significant number of Peace 3 and Interreg 4 funded projects. This has allowed a number of very worthwhile projects to be implemented in the county. Tourism is vitally important for Donegal, and Donegal County Council is driving a number of initiatives.
One of my key tourism projects going forward is the development of Sleeve League as a major flagship tourism product for the county. We have been able to achieve success with secured funding from two sources, one being Foilshire Ireland and the other being Interreg. So we've secured two sources of funding for the development of Sleeve League. We're now working with the stakeholders down there, that's the landowners, in developing that product and project, and we're hoping to deliver that over the next 2 years, which we will see Sleeve League being developed into a major flagship tourism product that will give visitors a fantastic experience once they visit Sleeve League and the surrounding areas of Southwest Donegal.
An example of Donegal County Council's involvement in the local community is the development of the Donegal Islands Film and Radio Archive. It contains over 40 hours of film, TV and radio news material that can be freely accessed by the public.
It's a project about islands, primarily for island populations. In the simplest form, it's a collection of material about their home areas to give an understanding to themselves or a recollection of what island populations have undergone since the 1950s. Some have been successful in developing their islands and some unfortunately have not. It also will add obviously to the tourism product, given that the archive will be available publicly within the culture and tourism centres on the islands.
The Mayor of Donegal County Council, Noel McBride, has no doubt that decentralisation has been a major success.
Well, we have our decentralised offices located throughout Donegal. They bring local government to the people. That was the original plan, that decentralised offices would bring the services that were always available here in Lifford closer to the people. Those decentralised services, it brings it to a local level. And that is vitally important, I think, within the democratic system. It's vitally important to our citizens. The services that are available, as I said, able to tax your car, planning issues, housing issues, they're all there, they're all available in the decentralised offices. And that, I think, is vitally important to all people in Donegal.
Donegal is open for business, and Donegal County Council will continue to be a key player in driving the economic, social and cultural development of the county in the years ahead.